What is pippity-pippity? Hopping YouTube, Katrina Galeen here, and I'm back with another video. If you're new to my channel, hey cousin, subscribe. If you're not new, welcome back to my channel. So I'm about to do a wig install, but I thought I'd just show y'all me taking out my hair and washing it and all that stuff too, because why not? Or I could just split up into two different videos, which is probably what I'm gonna do. But I'm about to go ahead and take out these braids that I actually did myself. It's getting pretty old, as you can see. So I'm about to go ahead and take out my hair, then we're gonna wash it, moisturize it.
Are you sure about that?
Wet a little bit, blow dry it, and then we're going to start the wig install. Catch me there. I had these braids in for about 4 weeks now. I always keep my hair in for like a month, unless it's like a wig install. Now I'll leave it in for like 2 weeks, maybe reinstall it, or I'll just do something else. But yeah, it's time for a change. So first thing I'm gonna do is cut all these braids short so I don't have to take them out from all the way down here. And I could just take them out from like down here. So let's go do that. So y'all, I cut all of the braids, but I actually really like them short. I think I'm gonna get hair like this. Like, this is so cute. Like, yeah, I can't wait to do this wig, because with this wig, it's gonna look just like this. Yeah. Anyways, let's start the takedown process. Y'all see my room? Let's start the takedown process. So yeah, I actually just went to the beauty supply store instead, and I got some stuff that I needed. Got this stuff right here. It's apparently $62. Not understanding why. But I got the purple shampoo for my wig when I bleach it. Hot comb, cause I don't have one for my wig. Stocking caps. Silicone mitts, cause it's gonna get kind of dry. This eyebrow archer. For my lace, and you know, just some little other stuff like some lashes, stuff to moisturize your hair. And my boyfriend wanted to dye his hair, so but yeah, we're all ready. And my wig is out for delivery right now, so I'm about to hurry up, take my hair down, period, take my hair down, and be ready for my wig to come. Right, Zay? Mm-hmm. Say it,
yeah.
Goodness. Oh, so guys, my wig just got delivered. Love that for us, right, Zay?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so as soon as I'm done taking out my hair, I'm gonna drive over to the house to pick up the wig. I already got all of my materials, now I'm just waiting to finish my hair. I don't think I'm gonna wash it. I was gonna wash it, but I don't feel like washing it, so. I also don't feel like blow drying it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna braid it up like this. Say, what you doing? What you doing?
I'm finna go, come on.
You finna go?
Yup.
We finna go. We finna go! So y'all, my hair looks so short from that angle, but done taking out my hair. came to the house to get my wig. Anyways, y'all, we came out here to get my wig and we did. Zay wanted to play basketball, so that's what we're doing. But after this, we're gonna go to the house, braid down my hair, and put a wig on. Actually, I gotta customize it first. I gotta pluck it. I bought tweezers. I have to bleach it. I have bleach, and I have to bleach the knots. So y'all just stay tuned. I'm gonna show y'all everything that came with the wig in the next clip. So wait. So y'all, okay, y'all, so for real, this is the wig. Well, this is the bag it comes in. It comes with two wig caps in a nude color. Even though I already went and bought the wig caps because I didn't think it would come with any. Let's see what we have in the bag. So here is the wig. So y'all, I got a 22-inch wig. It is body wave. Okay. Okay. Oh my goodness. Who do you know? Period. Okay, no shedding. Okay. Baby hair is in front. Okay. Oh, pardon space. Parking space. And just off rip, guys, the hair is soft, it's bouncy, it's full. I'm really loving it. On the inside, it has what, 1, 2, 3, 4 combs and adjustable straps to make it tighter as needed. But yeah, so far, we're loving it. Last thing in the bag, and some lashes. I'm not gonna wear these. One more braid. Braid on. Kinda big, cause anybody got time for this? And this all gonna be one braid too. And y'all, got these nails on. I got these nails on, so I can't even braid for real. So I most definitely was not gonna do no small braids. It was doing too much. Yeah, I'm just so excited because it's skunk stripe. Like, I'm so scared to do this skunk stripe. Like, and do I want it in the middle or do I want two patches on the side? One, I'm just confused. Yeah, I'm so scared. I think I'm gonna just do one in the middle because two on the side. I mean, yeah, the side is cool and all. It's cool and whatnot, but like, I don't know, y'all. I'm not braiding up this end part. My nails is in the way. So yo, get into it. Let's start this wig process, y'all. Cause I wasn't gonna start it earlier because ain't nobody got time to start it earlier. My hair not even braided down. So I'm like, yeah. Oh, what I did with the end of the braid just now, I just slipped it through the other braid, so. Let's get into this wig process. Come with me. So first I'm gonna start by trying on the wig, y'all. Cause why the freak not? Definitely is tight. Will not need the adjustable strap. Y'all don't know, it's been so long since I had body wave hair. Like, I definitely want something like that. So y'all, first thing I'm gonna do is actually put this wig back on because I need to part out which piece I'm gonna be dyeing. So y'all, I want to go for a middle piece. So y'all, I think this is the amount I'm gonna do. Yep. Put this in the ponytail. Oh, actually no, put this in the ponytail. Cause I also want a piece in the back. Right there. Should I be? So guys, ignore that. Let's get started on this bleaching process though, from 1B to 613. So guys, this is what I'll be using to bleach my hair. It's 40 developer in a clear bottle. I don't know what's the difference between clear and cream, so don't ask me. And some regular BW2 bleaching powder. Let me go get something to put it in. So y'all, I'm just taking a basic little plastic cup and a plastic knife. So I don't have to wash nothing out or try my best to clean it. I could just go ahead and throw it away. So I'm gonna start with my bleach. So as you guys can see, I was not measuring that at all. So let's just mix it up and see if it's enough. I mean, it should be, right? Yeah, so now that it's thick enough, we can go ahead and start putting that on the wig. Dang, I meant to get some aluminum foil. So I'm gonna start at the front. So y'all, I couldn't record everything because I'm running out of storage, but I just put the bleach in there. I'm gonna leave it in for 30 minutes and we're gonna come back and see what it's looking like, okay? So y'all, this is not the color that I wanted it to be. It's brown, so we're gonna go ahead and dye it one more time, hopefully, and maybe we can get it to 613 the way I need it. So y'all, this is what it's looking like right now. Not the color. I'm gonna cry if it doesn't work out. But this color is actually not bad either, so regardless. Then I'm kind of glad I got a little bit on there because it'll look more natural like that. Like, that's kind of cute to me. But all I know is if this don't work out, I just do it. So y'all, I got super mad last night and I quit. And I tried it one more time this morning. I don't know what color it's gonna be when I put this on comb, but whatever color it is, that's just gonna be what color it is. Right, Zay?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Oh, Zay also got his hair bleached this morning. Check it out. Anyways, yeah. So we're gonna go get Zay haircut, and then I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna bleach the knots on this wig, and we're gonna start the whole installation process. Be right back, y'all. So y'all, I don't know if I told y'all this, but y'all got real mad up last night. Oh, I did tell y'all that right before I went to go get Zay haircut. But, so yeah, I just came back and bleached my knots. Then I bleached the little strips in the back right there. Then I just washed it out with some purple shampoo. And this is what it's looking like. It's the front, the knots, two pieces in the back. So what I'm about to do is go ahead and blow dry it. I'm gonna put it on my head and blow dry it just so I can it'll work better. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and blow dry the wig and we're gonna see what it's giving. If it's giving Cruella, if it's giving black and white, if it's giving motion picture, if it's giving 60s. We're about to find out. Start the blow drying process. We're gonna start with our chi heat protectant. My heat protectant kind of come out weird, so I sprayed on my hand first. knit that together and put it on the hair. Yeah, if y'all look, y'all can see that right there. I don't really like that, but I think that it might be better for me to have darker roots. I just don't know if that dark color should be brown, but I might go back to blue to the green later if it don't look great, but we're gonna find out. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start with my ball cap method, and I'm gonna go ahead and use the new cap that they gave to me. Once you put it on, you're gonna want to pull it back so that you can put your edges away. Okay, and to push my edges back, I'm gonna be using this Balm Goo. G is Balm Collection, that's what it's from. Okay, y'all, and I'm gonna be taking my edge brush since I can't find that other brush I normally use. I'm gonna just push it back. And you wanna make sure all your edges is there, because if any ounce of edges come off, you're gonna be very much upset. So I'm gonna take my blow dryer and I'm gonna just blow dry it back while I do it. I'm gonna put it on high heat so it can hurry up. Now y'all, since that's dry, I'm gonna also go in with my Got to Be Glue spray just to support that hole. Y'all, what the freak? What the freak was it spraying at the first time? Alright, now get started. So one more time, just go in with the edge brush and the blow dryer and dry it up. So y'all, once that's done, you're gonna pull the cap down all the way as far as you can go and cut out your ear tabs. Stop. You know what I'm doing. You got it. And it's okay if it does that little thing right there that mine's doing. Same thing to the other side. All right, both ear tabs are cut out. Normally people go in with the glue. I'm gonna go in with my She Is Balm hair, with a free Balm Glue, my She Is Balm Glue. And just outline my hairline. Thank you. little bit more layer. It's just so I can be reassured that it's gonna stick, because normally this area right here never sticks for me. Now I don't have time for the BS today. Actually, I need to cut some more of this off. Okay, y'all, so this is completely dry. So now I'm gonna go in with some free spray to help it. Just kind of rub that in so it'll be easy for me to see my skin. And you just want to blow that in to completion too. So I'll be right back when I'm done. So yeah, that's finally freaking done. That took forever. That's why I hate to my wigs. But now I'm just going to go ahead and start to cut the cap off. So y'all learned this great tip. When you're cutting, pull it downward and that'll help it do something. I don't know. Feels like it just seems like it works, but for whatever her plan was. I know y'all probably watching like, girl, just cut it. Yeah, I'm scared. Every time I get to this point, I'll be scared. So yeah, so I'm done. I totally forgot I brought this up. I bought this eyebrow archer just to cut this off. So yeah, now that I cut all this junk off, this is when you try on the wig. This is when you're trying to wet it. Make sure everything that's cut off, I mean everything that's left over, doesn't need to be cut off. Whatever, y'all know what I'm trying to say. Stop messing with me. That's my whole ball cap right here. Can you see it on this side? Only on this side. I thought that would happen. So let's cut some more off, I guess. Even though my hair is right there, it's all in the family. What do you mean? Hey, free little Steve. Y'all. Okay, y'all, so apparently I didn't have the wig on all the way. That's all that's really out. And even the wigs. So I'm just now. But yeah, so this is what it's looking like so far. I'm gonna go ahead and put the makeup on my cap and on the inside of the wig to help it blend. And my tip to y'all is that whenever you're putting your makeup on your cap, I say get one shade lighter than what you really are, because your scalp is not the same color as you. Your scalp is lighter than your regular skin tone. So I always say get one shade above for wig application. And normally even with this color, I mix it with a darker color. I just can't find my darker color right now. And this kinda already makeup on this brush, which is why it stretched like that. And that's because I did some hair last night. I did a wig install as well. Okay, now you can go ahead and put the makeup on the inside of the wig as well. Since I'm using liquid, I'm trying not to put that much on the brush because it's liquid and I don't want it to, yeah, I know how the liquid be on the inside of the cap and stuff. Hold on, y'all, I'll do that because I don't want to take up too much storage. I know how my phone be. Okay, y'all, now one more tip. Whenever you put your makeup on your wig cap, spray got to be glue spray just so it doesn't seep anywhere, or when you put it on, it's not like pressing in to go on your braids or nothing. Just always do that and blow dry it afterwards. So y'all, I'm gonna go ahead with the application process. So let's start putting this wig on. First thing I'm gonna do is comb my hair back like this so that I can see all the lace properly. And put this into a ponytail. I'm actually be right back. I'm about to go put this hot comb on the stove because I know I'm gonna need it pretty soon. All right, be back. Okay, y'all, so hot comb is on the stove. Where's my eyebrow right here? I'm gonna use this. No, I'm not. I'm gonna use these scissors to cut off my ear tabs. Obviously, this is too long. I can't even see over there. I'm going to the mirror. Y'all, please don't be stressed about cutting off hair because the hair that's in your ear tabs you cannot use. So if that's gonna have to be cut off, it's just gonna have to be cut off. And I used to have a problem with cutting that off because I'm like, I paid for this. Why the freak? Why would I just waste it? I'm wasting money if I cut it off. But hair's not gonna look good without it, y'all. I mean, yeah. Is that what I mean? So my ear tab, y'all. I'm gonna do the other one and come back. So yeah, this is what I did off camera because I messed up. Look what I did. Cut that junk. And I tried my best to part it. Still cut that junk though. Don't matter, cause it's in the bag. Right now it's in the bag. It's in the bag. Sleepy bag said, Ligori said, it's already too late. So y'all, let's go ahead and make some slits in my lace so it'll be easier for me to cut off. And personally, I like doing three of them because one in the middle, two on the side. Okay, y'all, so three slit. Now I'm gonna fold it back and start applying my glue. But first, I gotta find it. Be right back. So guys, today I'm using this goat glue by Define. Epitome of Perfection. It's waterproof glue. This is an ounce. So yeah. Let's get it on. I'm gonna start my side because I'm actually worse with my side. So let's just hurry up and get that out the way. I'm gonna start by putting a little drop. Well, actually, I'm gonna just do a line. Okay, yeah, so I'm doing it in the wrong spot. So I'm gonna do it right here where my lace is gonna be at. I'm gonna put a little bit more because that wasn't enough. I don't know if y'all can see that, but it wasn't enough. Okay. So that right there should be enough. And I'm just gonna blow dry that for a little bit to get it tacky. Okay, so it's tacky. I'm gonna go ahead and slide this down. And I'm going to take my comb. I'm just gonna comb this hair back so that's not stuck in the glue, and I'm pushing my lace into the glue so it'll stay. Okay, now I'm gonna blow dry that some. So y'all, right now I'm not too much worried about that right there because I know how to go ahead and clean that up. But I'm just not gonna do it yet because I wanna get the rest of this laid and slayed as well. I'm just trying to see, should I go to this side now or the middle? Let's do the side. So again, I'm gonna go in with my goat glue. It's about to find where I just set it at. Oh, I don't got no glasses on. Oh, there it is. Yeah, when I don't have glasses on, I need my glasses to find my glasses. That's just to give you an idea of how blind I am. But let's go ahead with this side. Yeah, barely anything even came off, y'all. Gotta do it again. These are just so thick. I wish I could be thick like this glue. So y'all, it's been a little minute. Let's take this off and see if I'm wrong or right. Okay. Okay. This is a step in the right direction. Okay. Okay, hold on, y'all. So y'all, in order to make this look better, I'm gonna go ahead and try to do some edges and cut off the extra stuff that don't need to be there. And I'll be back. My phone keep not having no space, so I gotta cut the video short, y'all. So y'all, I should have mentioned to y'all that I'm terrible at doing edges. So this is what they're looking like so far. So guys, I am absolutely hating it right now. Absolutely. So what I'm going to do is one more time, I'm gonna pray to God. And I'm gonna put this free spray on this lace one more time and put this headband on. And I'm gonna try to clean it off. And we're just gonna see what happens from there. Hopefully it melts all the way, because hopefully it melts all the way. And while it is drying, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm not gonna straighten it because I don't look good in straightening hair, but I do want curls. We thought that would be so cute if it would just melt. I'm getting upset. So I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna go put this free spray and this headband back on and try to curl my hair. Be right back. So guys, I'm not sure if you've seen these flat irons before, but these are these Solil flat irons. These are my good flat irons. These are the flat irons I use when I need a miracle. And right now I definitely need a miracle. So I put this back down. I do need to clean up some of the glue and stuff that's on me. Oh, I forgot to cut this piece off. But let me go cut this off actually. So y'all, now that most of that is cut off, I gotta wait till I pull up this to cut the rest of it off. But now that that is cut off, I'm gonna go ahead and end with my cheek. Oh, I didn't know it had a name. Catatonic hydration internal, that's cool. But I'm gonna go in my cheek iron guard heat protectant. And I told y'all earlier my jump was messed up, so I'm spraying it in my hand first. Like I said, if you talk about me, God gonna get you, because he don't play about me, so please leave me alone, child. And really with heat protectant, a little bit goes a long way. So don't try to use too much. You'll know when to stop. What a freak. Y'all freaking random numbers keep texting me.
But let's try to start this process.
So y'all, whenever I flat iron hair, I like to do the chase method because it works amazingly. So I'm just gonna start with a medium size. Oh, well, it actually looks small. It's actually kind of small, but a small section. And we're gonna start this process. I'm gonna curl away from, my face because I want it to go away from my face. And I don't really want like curls, curls like that. Like that's not what I wanted at all. But
So y'all, this is what it look like curled.
Y'all, this is what it's looking like curled. This side got combed out, but this side didn't. So I'm about to go ahead and brush this side out. And I'm just gonna like rotate the brush while I'm doing it to keep like the curls curled, but giving it a fuller look at the same time. So yeah, you could do like this, like that, like that's cute or whatever, right? So let's take this headband off.
Yeah, we're about to take the headband off. I'm gonna tell you one thing. This junk don't come out cute, I'm gonna be mad. And I'm gonna take it off and do it again. Why not even do it again? I might just take it off.
So y'all, this is the final look for the day. I think I'm gonna do it again. Yeah, I'm not feeling it.